One of the most devastating and intimidating Churchill variants was the Churchill Crocodile flamethrower. It reached Normandy after D-Day.
The Crocodile was one of these other derivatives, usually a derivative of a Churchill, sometimes a Cromwell, usually a Churchill, which was in fact a mobile flamethrower. It towed behind it a great big tank of petroleum jelly, and it had a projector on the front, and it fired flame.
The flame gun would blast a jet of flame, well over 100 yards. It stuck to everything it touched. It's a terrible weapon. Quite often, it would work in conjunction with the Avery. So you would find that the Avery would fire its bomb and crack open a blockhouse, and if the occupants didn't come out immediately, a crocodile would approach within range and flame it. And the result was the flame fuel would drop down the tracks into the interior, and that usually got them out.
Very useful for clearing out bunkers or trench systems. Pretty nasty way to kill people, and in general, if your crocodile broke down, you legged it, because both sides, totally illegally and quite unofficially, shot people with flamethrowers.
Often the mere appearance of a crocodile was enough for people to put their hands up. Conversely, if a crocodile crew was captured, they could frequently find no mercy being shown to them. I won't say they liked their work. It's been expressed to me by former crocodile crewmen that they considered it inhuman. You can well imagine the result, what it looks like, and, you know, once seen, never forgotten. And it really was very unpleasant. But war is unpleasant and it got results. That's what you're after.
They were a particularly horrific weapon, and certainly Churchill crocodile crews could expect very short shrift from Germans if they were captured. However, it has to be said that in many occasions, merely the presence of a flamethrower tank was enough to force Germans who might otherwise have held out to surrender immediately. So perhaps it was not quite such an inhumane weapon as might be imagined.